also said Defined Lines. I'm so excited to finally not have to skip these songs whenever I hear them on TikTok, because I've been trying to just sit down and listen to them all at once, but I had to wait for that. I have heard Watermelon Sugar and Adore You and Lights Up, because I watched the Lights Up music video, and Watermelon Sugar and Adore You are on the radio all the fucking time. I think I've heard all the other songs. I heard Canyon Moon because I was shopping and it was playing in the background. I've heard Sunflower because I'm on TikTok. I've heard She because I'm on TikTok. TikTok will not let me live. I've heard Golden because I'm on TikTok. But Golden, isn't Golden the one with the changed lyrics when you hear it live? And I love those lyrics. But basically, I'm on Harry Styles TikTok, so I've heard a lot of these songs, but I've not meant to. I've never like heard them all like in their entirety. And I've never seen the music videos for some of these, so I've never seen Golden. Let's watch it. I do like the song though. I know I love Golden. I'm so excited to finally hear it so I could like actually listen to it. Also, I think it's very funny that I've never heard Harry's first album, considering I have it on CD. I've never opened it though. So, but finally I can listen to Fine Lines. I'm so excited. Run! See, he looks so much older here. Not to get canceled on Twitter, but I don't know how anyone thinks this man is a heterosexual. just, I know we can't like assume people are gay and like stereotypes, but like that man is not straight. just by context clues, like at some point you just gotta be like, people don't have to come out. If they just are like that, then you can just safely be like, yeah. Instead of assumption, it's an inference. Anyways, not the point of that video. I never realized Golden was sad. And I knew a lot of the words. I knew that the change lyrics were, he is broken, and I'm hoping someday he'll open. I know they just can't because that's the change line. I never, though, like, I knew that the lyrics, and I knew the lyrics, and I guess I knew that the lyrics were sad, but it never really registered that this was gonna be a sad song. So when I was, like, hearing him sing those words, I was just like, oh, this song is very sad. But the vibes? So happy. Such a good vibe. Such happy, good vibes for such a sad song. I love that contradiction. I love that in music. So, Golden's kind of my favorite song right now, and I knew I was gonna like Golden. Because of those change lyrics that he does live, I knew I was gonna like Golden, but oof, I love Golden. And we love a good social distance music video. Yes, King. Watermelon Sugar. I'm so tempted just to skip it because, oh my god, I have heard this song so many fucking times. But we're not going to. We're gonna give every song their moment. It's dedicated to touching. Huh. I remember when we could do that before COVID. BC. Just look at what he's for. Strawberries. It is. Oh, fun. Oh, it's the fish. Louis the fish. I'm so fucking tired of Watermelon Sugar. I really liked that song when it came out, but my god, I cannot escape that song. It is so overplayed and I hate it now. I don't hate it, but like I'm so tired of it. And if I never have to hear it again, I would be more than happy. Okay, not to speculate on a real person's sexuality, but for the sake of analyzing that song, we're all supposed to be under the assumption that Watermelon Sugar is a euphemism for liking women. Yes, that is the connection that we make based off of that music video, yes. And Harry is like, I think the official statement is that he's unlabeled, which means he's not straight. So many people like to take that to mean that it doesn't mean that he's not straight. It doesn't mean anything. And I'm just like, it does. It means he's not straight because straight people are not unlabeled. They have a label. It's called straight. And people really like to do a sort of catch-22 with that to be like, you can't say he's not straight. He's unlabeled. And I'm like, nope, that means he's not straight. Anyways, it doesn't matter what I think. It doesn't matter what my opinions on his sexuality are. It doesn't, because it's none of my business. That being said, I don't think he likes women. But there's no reason for me to not believe that he isn't unlabeled, that what he says is not true. There's no reason for me to not say that. But I also think that in the very homophobic media industry, it is preferred for him to be unlabeled because it's easy to market him to a wide audience, because he gets the points of being like a a little bit gender fluid, a little bit bisexual. He gets all those nice fun, he gets the queer audience with that, but because he's not explicitly any part of the LGBTQ plus community, he's allowed to also be marketed to middle America. And I think his label and all of like the media would prefer to keep him unlabeled, whether he is or is not. Again, I'm not saying he is or he isn't, because it's not my place to say, and like there's no reason to not believe when he says he's unlabeled, but whether he is or he isn't, it's probably preferred for him to stay that way for money and marketing reasons. Now, does that mean that he does actually like women? Who knows? That music video would make you believe, yeah, sure, he does like women. Do I think that that's true? None of my business. The answer is no, but it's none of my business. It doesn't matter what I think. And you might say, Sam, why do you believe that? I just think it's very interesting that the public narrative around Harry ever since he was 16, an actual child, an actual minor, has been that he's a womanizer and that all he does is just sleep with random women and likes women and likes to just use them or whatever. The fact that that narrative started with a 16-year-old is already sus, but they've never given up that narrative and we're now just supposed to believe it because he's an adult, and I'm like, no. He's never been that type of person. Even when he was a child, and then media wanted to be like, he's dating someone who was like 30? That was so fucking weird. Y'all remember that? And it's just also very interesting how, despite him being like pro-equality, the only women he's ever linked with are thin, skinny, famous white models. What's up with that? You're saying not one plus-size person, not one person of color, only skinny white models? And they're always models, so they're always people who would get clout from being, like, romantically involved with Harry Styles. It's all just very suspicious. I just think, you know, if he really liked women, why doesn't he date a normal person? Why are they all this very specific type? A type that just so happens to be good for marketing reasons. I'm just saying that all of his relationships just so happen to be stunts. So if he really liked women, you would think there would just be, you know, different kinds of women, unless he's just like really racist. You know, it's just like the things that he promotes are so contradictory to the image that the media has of him that it doesn't make any sense. Like, you would think, oh, he's very pro-equality, pro-everything, pro-supporting women, pro-supporting all kinds of women, and yet he's only ever dated the Eurocentric beauty standard of women. What's up with that? Doesn't make any sense. So that just leads me to believe he doesn't actually like women, but like, it's not my business. Again, it's not my fucking business. Anyways, adore you. We'll see the fish. Another season of the world, there has never been a land quite like the Isle of Aroda. Aroda? Oh my god. And eventually so did the boy. We all love screaming into jars. I definitely seen this music video. This video came out after my birthday. Slowly the fish. Not the bullying a fish. Was he trying to carry water in a paper bag? Even makes the milk taste like tacos. If you love something, set it free. So this is supposed to be off like a British Isle. Like it's supposed to be. She said on an odd number day, which caused everyone in town to lose their hair. Damn. But that's another story. So wait, why does the narrator sound Latin? It sounds like he has a Latin accent. Why? I'm not saying he can't be Latin and then also British, but also just a bit confusing. Anyways, what a cute story. It's a good, you know, narrative of be yourself. And if that's weird, there are other weird people who can be your friend. And they might be a fish. I like Adore You. Again, a tad bit overplayed, but I do like Adore You more than I like Watermelon Sugar. I feel like the lyrics are a bit stronger and the story's a bit more fun, so I prefer Adore You. But again, just a tad overplayed. Golden. Golden and Kiwi. Such a good song, but lights up. I've heard this song. Let's just listen to it again. Oh, that's the outfit for Falling. Yes? Maybe? No. Who knows? I might just be making things up. Yeah, I have nothing against that song. I just feel like lyrically, there's not much there. And I always look for lyrics first when I'm listening to a song. I would always prefer good lyrics over good just, like, instrumentals. And, like, the instrumentals and the melody and the singing, all of that in the song, very good, but the lyrics are just sort of meh. So I'm not like obsessed over the song. The music video, though, I think is very cool. I watched it when it first came out, and I was like, wow. Now I'm just sort of like, meh. But, like, the motorcyclist is supposed to be that actor, that gay actor. But, like, he never takes off his helmet. It was just very interesting. That was, like, that's, like, a fun fact for this music video. Like, why would he, if his helmet never comes off, why did it need to be, like, a named actor? I forget his name. Just very interesting. What's the next song? Cherry Hawk. This is that song with that voicemail at the beginning that's supposed to be about that French model girl. But I don't believe that. Not 420. Oh, is this the... Oh, is this the Take Him Walking in Your Gallery song? There's a piece of you in how I drive. Take it as a compliment. The Suspenders. Does he take you walking around his parents' gallery? That song's not about her. I don't care. I also just, like, don't like her. Not because she, like, dated Harry Styles, but because she did that really insensitive Halloween costume. But we're not gonna get into it. I like the storytelling of the song. Again, one of my favorite parts. I like the lyrics. The lyrics are really strong. I do feel like the chorus, just a tad too long. This song could just be, like, about 30 to 45 seconds shorter, and it'd be perfect. To me, this song is very clearly about Louis, but, like, you can believe what you want. I don't think it really matters. I just think, you know, there's a piece of you in how I dress. I miss your accent. Also, at the end of the song, the little guitar that, like, goes underneath the voicemail sounds a lot to me like Sweet Creature. And we know Sweet Creature's not about her. So, just thoughts to think. I like the lyrics of the song. I don't think I really like the sound of it, though. I feel like musically and, like, vocal wise, I'm not a fan of how it sounds, but I feel like lyrically I really like it. Oh god, Falling.
There's a certain kind of person.
I've been waiting to listen to this song because I know it is heartbreaking. This is the one where he plays the piano underwater. I'm so excited. Oh my god, I've seen so many people talk about it. Oh, look at the drama! Look at the lighting! Look at the spoke! Oh, I love the drama. I love a king who can play piano.
I'm in my bed.
You're in hers too. Every time you see me, I got some new shoes.
And I'm well aware I write too many songs about you. The coffee's out. The Beachwood Cafe.
Absolutely stunning. Oh, beautiful. Absolutely gorgeous music video. Oh my god. Oh. Oh, what a good song. First of all, stunning, absolutely stunning, mate. That music video, absolutely so fucking beautiful. Wow, 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 wow. The water, the sunlight, the lighting, the fog. I don't know if they filmed it twice, but in some of the scenes, his dress looks like it's pink, and then some of them it looks like it's blue. And I don't know if it's lighter or if they filmed it twice with two different outfits, but we love the color-coded theming that goes with the album. Absolutely stunning. Also, the song is heartbreaking. Heartbreaking, absolutely beautiful. Oh, what a good song. It's like, there were some songs going into this album that I knew I would like. Falling and Golden. And I was right. They're so good. They're so good. Absolutely love it. Absolutely love it. Oh my god, what a fucking beautiful song. I just also, again, if you want to believe the straight Harry Styles narrative, how could he write so many songs about somebody who he's had not a long-term relationship with? just a bit interesting, just a bit of a to be so lonely. There's a music video. No, Treat People Kindness has the music video. To be so lonely. Is this a don't blame? It is. I'm just an arrogant son of a bitch who can't admit. Yeah, that sounds okay. I prefer, if you're gonna be a sad song, you have to commit to being a sad song. And the song's just sort of like melancholy. I'm not a fan of melancholy songs. Because melancholy is just sort of the general vibe of my life. So either you need to like make me sad, or you need to bring me up. You can't just like exist on my vibes. I'm already vibing at that level. Change the vibe. It's just sort of like a meh. I also feel like the chorus is just a bit like repetitive, but I do like the verses and I do like the lyrics. You know, everyone, when you hear it live, you love to scream, arrogant son of a bitch. It's just a fun line to scream. And I like the consistent theme of being like, don't call, apparently baby is a very sore subject to call Harry. It's really emotional for him. He's brought it up in two songs now. That's like the central theme. But I like that consistency to like connect these two songs. And then that would imply to be like, oh, what was that song? It was Cherry, wasn't it? Where he was like, don't call him what you called me. Don't call him baby. That was Cherry, yeah? He would be like, oh, whoever Cherry's about, it's about to be so lonely. I think it's about Louis. And I know that I'm right, so no point in arguing. She lives in daydreams with fame. Oh, I'm excited. I know this song's gonna be good. 6 minutes. Okay. You better earn every 6 minutes. You better earn all 6 minutes, Mr. Styles. If it has a long instrumental intro and outro, I'm... Louis timestamp. Not the chorus again. Just kind of ours. Oh, is it just a really long instrumental section? These are cool when they're live, but when it's just recorded, I don't care. Don't sing the chorus again. Give the bridge. Give the bridge. Or just let Mitch go off on the guitars. Go off. Go off here. Don't sing it. Okay, so it's just a really long instrumental. If he ends it with another chorus, I'm gonna be so mad. We don't need the chorus again. Give us a bridge. Give us something new. Give us something interesting. We get it, she lives in daydreams. And you don't know why. No, it's still going. Okay. Oh, that's it. Okay. Yeah. I don't have anything against long instrumentals. I just, you know, I will skip them. I'm a big fan of lyrics. There's no lyrics. I'm okay. Yeah, I did not think that this song needed to be this long. I think maybe a concert version of it could be this long. Live music is always way more impressive than just recorded instrumentals. I like the lyrics. I like the story of it. The chorus, a bit repetitive, considering that the verses, especially after the first one, were so short. And then the instrumental just kept going. But not a bad song. I like the instrumentals. Despite me not liking instrumentals, like a long instrumental section as like a concept, I feel like the instrumentals themselves were good. They were strong. I like the sound of it. The music was nice. Oh, Sunflower, I'm so excited. I've been waiting to listen to Sunflower. I think that is his best song. It is not my favorite. My favorite is still Falling and Golden, because those hit me the most emotionally. That's what I like out of music. But I feel like lyrically and instrumentally, this is the strongest song. I think that this is a song that would have been written by Ryan Ross, which in my mind is the highest compliment you could give somebody, as Ryan Ross is the best writer of our generation. Just like, yeah, the writing style of this song is very Ryan Ross. in just like the big complicated words, but also like the really like the layers of meaning in them. It's just really good. It's really strong. I definitely need to like listen to it a few more times to really get it, but I can already like look at it and like appreciate that it is a very good song. And I knew it was going to be a good song. So again, not my favorites, but it's definitely up there. I love the themes of it. I think it's fun. It does not get boring. Every single second gives you something new, and I love it. What's the next one? Oh, Canyon Moon. I love Canyon Moon. Staring at the ceiling. 2 weeks and I'll be home. Carry the feeling. Through Paris, all through Rome. I like that song. I think it's a good song. I think Canyon Moon's a nice, fun song. Again, I like the storytelling behind it. I like the way that he sings the song. I like the melody of the song. I like the instrumentals. Nice, good, fun song. Again, not one of my favorites. It's gonna take a lot to get to the number one spot, which is currently tied. Well, no, Golden's my favorite song, but Fog is a very close second. So you're gonna have to really wow me to fight either of those for the top spot. And Canyon Moon doesn't do that, but it is good in its own way. What is the next song? Treat People with Kindness. Time to watch the music video. It just came out.
Hey, yeah. You guys need to be okay.
Y'all like 3 weeks ago. Okay. We love a dance. We love black people. Sometimes they're just not in videos. I hope this was filmed pre-COVID, because that's a lot of people. That was cute. We love the matching outfits. We love a little song and dance.
There's a certain...
No. Shut the fuck up. Ugh, another long song. I bet it's just a long instrumental again. That's the last song on the album. It is the title track. Not a bad song. I get what he was trying to do. It's just not for me. Again, long instrumentals and repetitive lyrics are just sort of not my thing. I get that it's supposed to be like a motif. And the more you say, it's really supposed to drive home the point, but like, it's just going on for a bit too long. Like 3 or 4 minutes, too many for me. But I do appreciate the instrumentals for what they are. The instrumental's very beautiful, just it's not my thing for a long instrumental. But that is all of Harry Styles' music, I believe. Let's just double check that, because I don't think he did like a bunch of singles like the other boys have. He did just sort of his two straight albums. Yeah. So that's it. Okay, cool. Good music. I never thought Harry Styles was gonna make bad music. I never thought his music was ever bad. There was never that question like there was with some of the other boys. I do like more of his music than I do like Liam and Louis, but I also do feel like his style of music is not one that I usually gravitate towards. And there will be a few songs that I'll probably just like skip through just because the music isn't usually what I'm looking for, you know? But, you know, Golden? Oh, I love Golden. I love Golden so much. Golden's so good. Falling is so good. Sweet Creature, beautiful. Kiwi's always been good. Yeah. His music's good. I hope he does win a Grammy. I always thought of Grammys as this like great prestigious award only for the very, very top tier 100% good music, but like, it really just is a competition between your peers, and if your peers really suck, then there's no reason you shouldn't win a Grammy. Looking at Harry Styles' competition, I definitely think he deserves to win, just as do BTS, because like, I bring BTS into every single video. BTS also deserves to win the Grammy. He puts out good music. He's apparently writing a third album. I'm going to be very excited to be able to listen to that, because his first album has a very different sound than his second album. There are similar themes where he like sort of leans towards like folksy music, and I just think that's a bit odd. I don't know where he got that influence from, but it seems to be where his music style is headed, because his first album is very folksy, sort of country, and then there's some tracks on Fine Line, like or is it Canyon Moon, which sounds kind of folksy, which I thought is fun. That line, though, in Fine Line, put a price on emotion, I'm looking for something to buy, I never thought was sung like that. I always thought it was sung similar to Woman, where it's a bit more alternative, like in a like more rock sort of more an aggressive tone, but it's just very soft and fine line, which I was not expecting. Because I've read a lot of Harry Styles, like, lyrics, but I never actually, like, listened to the songs. I think a Harry Styles concert would be a great, grand old time. But after listening to his music, I don't think I need to be in the pit. I don't think, you know, there's some people who fucking love his music, who think he is the best songwriter in the goddamn world and would, like, die to go to a Harry Styles concert. I don't think I'm one of those people, and that's okay. He's not that person for me. For me, that would be pre-split Panic! The Disco or My Chemical Romance, which I am going to see whenever the pandemic wants to end. So I was like, I was planning to get Harry Styles tickets because he just rescheduled his concert, which I'm assuming he's going to have to reschedule again because I doubt anything's going to be okay in August. I was like, I need to get pit tickets. I think I'll be fine. I think I could just get regular tickets and I'll have a good time. Because there are some people that I know that, like, love Harry Styles. And, like, it would be way more meaningful for them to have a pit ticket than I will. Like, I'm very casual with my enjoyment of Harry Styles. Like, I think his music is good. But, like, is he my all-time favorite artist ever? No. He is not. But I do like Fine Line. I think Fine Line is a better album than his self-titled, which is good. You always want your albums to get better. And I can see that he's sort of honing his sound. I hope that his third album is better than his last album. That's all we want for our artists. That's all we want for our faves. I've been filming for over 2 hours, and I need to go to sleep. But let me know what you thought of Harry's music. Are you an all-time Harry Styles fan? Did you completely disagree with everything that I said but stayed till the end anyways? If so, thank you. Let me know what you thought. What do you think of Harry Styles' music? Is there something in these songs that I'm not missing that will make me love them more? I don't think that there is. I think I get them for what they are, and it's just not for me. Not that I don't like it, I just think that this isn't my go-to sound of music. But it's good. I wish he would write another song like Kiwi. That was such a good fucking song. I know he has some, like, unreleased tracks that he'll sing live, like Medicine and Anna, which I've heard. Very good. Medicine is like Kiwi, but I don't think we'll ever get a recorded version of Medicine because he hates us. Fucking love Medicine. I want more songs like Medicine and Kiwi, but, you know, Falling and Golden, I'll take more of that too. But yes, H3, whenever that comes out, best believe I will be here making a video about it. But that means we only have two boys left to go. We have Zayn and his three fucking albums. And then we have Niall, just with Flicker and Heartbreak Weather. And I like a lot of Niall's music, because it's very generic. That's the thing with Harry's music that I will appreciate, despite me not liking it, is that he doesn't go for, except for like Watermelon Sugar and Adore You, which they really pushed, a lot of his music isn't like generic pop music, which I feel like some of the boys do. And like a generic pop music I will always like, because I'm a big fan of just generic pop music. I think it's fun, it's good to listen to, but he does like different music that speaks to him. And while it might not be something that I gravitate towards or connect with, I appreciate that he's making authentic music rather than just what will sell well. Not that there's anything wrong with that either, you know, gotta pay those bills, gotta pay for that $1 million mansion somehow. But yes, we have now listened to more solo music than not. We just gotta listen to Niall and Zayn, and I will be an official OT5 stan once again, okay? I've listened to all of Liam's music, all of Louis's music, all of Harry's music. Okay, we're getting through it. We're becoming an OT5 stan. Now people on Twitter can't bully me for not listening to their solo music. Now I don't listen to it by choice because I don't like it, not because I've been waiting to listen to it. Eventually I will have listened to all their solo music, which is very fun. But Harry's music, obviously, we all knew this, very good. I'm excited for his next album, and hopefully, let's all knock on some wood, he wins his fucking Grammy.